البحرين not different from the rest of the region. We still heavily dependent on hydrocarbons. Let's call it oil. The downward pressure on oil prices naturally has significantly reduced revenues. On the other side of the coin, you have continuous need for subsidies, continuous need for social spending, be it public housing, be it subsidies I referred to. So the pressure is on. I think this entire region will have a very challenging rest of 2015, and in my humble opinion, a very challenging 2016. How does that reflect on the banks? Much of the spending and the project here are dependent on government spending. So when governments, be it Bahrain, be it all the neighboring countries, either hold back on projects or shelve them or delay them, then you're talking about the trickle-down effects into the system, which eventually has to reach the banks, either from a providing facilities standpoint, from taking deposits, from financing companies that, that provide tires for contractors and so on, or fuel or catering and so on. So will this affect banks? I think indirectly it has to. It has to. Case in point, many of us bankers in Bahrain complain of how liquid we are. And while that sounds like not much of a problem, but when you have excess funds as a bank, you have to deploy those funds. Otherwise, you're not getting the returns for your shareholders and owners and so on. So in the absence of a clear strategy of government spending, then I think it will affect adversely in some way affect the banking sector in any country, not just Bahrain. You know, I tell people that if you want a restaurant, there's plenty of restaurants in Bahrain, and good ones too. But if you want a place that where you meet people like you, who are in the business community, of similar mind, similar interests, and I don't mind saying similar maybe status. If you like a place where you can network, and if you like a place where you feel you need some exclusivity in the way you're received, in the way you're treated, in the way you're served, then the Capital Club is a logical choice. There is not another place in Bahrain that is like the Capital Club. There is restaurants with bigger menus and more variety and so on, maybe even a bit cheaper. And by the way, I don't think the prices here are more expensive than good restaurants. But I genuinely and personally bias towards this club because as an executive, when I bring in a guest here, be it a client, be it a guest from outside of Bahrain, be it an ambassador and so on, when I come to the Capital Club, I know how I'm going to be treated. So, and let me go ahead and say it publicly. Do they make me look good in front of my guests? It hasn't failed yet. So yes, they make me look good. I walk in, they call me by name. They know my water preference. They know my menu preference, and this in the consistency in the staff that they have. You don't have a lot of staff turnover. So, you know, if you're looking for a restaurant and your major concern is to get the cheapest meal out there, that's fine. There's plenty of stuff out there. But this place is, in my mind, an exclusive spot in Bahrain to for business people to meet and to bring in clients that, as we say in Arabic, يبيضوا وجهك, you know, make you look good. So that's there's an unashamed endorsement to the Capital Club.